People and hundreds from at least 40 socio-political organizations took to the streets of Bengaluru on Wednesday against the anti-conversion bill. It's an absolutely unconstitutional bill. It's against the fundamental rights of freedom and liberty. The bill is not only against Christians and other religious minorities, but it's also against each and every one of us. Rajendra, an activist, spoke in Bengaluru. A nearly 150-year-old church in Karnataka's Chikkaballapur district, the St. Joseph's Church, was allegedly vandalized this morning around 5:30 a.m. Father Joseph Anthony Daniel of the church said St. Anthony's statue was broken, adding that this kind of vandalism hasn't happened before. The incident took place amid controversy over the anti-conversion bill that was tabled in the Karnataka Assembly. Prime Minister Narendra Modi today inaugurated 22 developmental projects worth over ₹870 crore in UP's Varanasi. Prime Minister laid the foundation stone for Banas Dairy Sankul. The dairy will be built at a cost of about ₹475 crore and will have a facility for processing 5 lakh litres of milk per day. Prime Minister Modi also distributed rural residential rights record called Ghaurani. Telangana reported 14 new Omicron cases in the last 24 hours, taking the state's tally to 38, the state health department said. Of the 14 patients, 12 are returnees from countries not in the at-risk category, while 2 are from at-risk countries. As many as 259 passengers were screened at Hyderabad Airport on Wednesday. Russian President Vladimir Putin said there is no room to retreat in a standoff with United States over Ukraine and added that military response would follow if West didn't drop its aggression. What US is doing in Ukraine is at our doorstep. Do they think we'll watch idly? Putin said. United States and the European Union have threatened economic sanctions against Russia if it invades Ukraine. Local fishermen in Andhra Pradesh rescued a whale shark, the world's largest fish, entangled in the shore fishing net on Thanthadi Beach in Visakhapatnam, said District Forest Officer Anand Shankar. The 2-ton shark was later guided back to the sea by the Forest Department officials, fishermen and wildlife conservationists, added the District Forest Officer. Social media accounts opposed to French President Emmanuel Macron have claimed that his wife Brigitte Macron was born male under the name Jean-Michel Trogneux. A lawyer for Brigitte Macron confirmed she is taking legal action against the false claims. The rumor started when a journal published an article in September this year claiming it had conducted a 3-year investigation into the First Lady Brigitte Macron's life.